Everyone, it's Justin again. Previously, we learned about absolute value functions, which are a special type of function called a piecewise function. In this video, before we go too deep into the complicated parts of piecewise functions, we're going to start simple by looking at a special type of piecewise function, step functions. So, what is a step function? Well, this is. A step function is a function where the outputs are defined as constant values for inputs in specific intervals. If that definition's a little confusing, think of it this way. On this graph, the output is -3 if the input is anything less than or equal to -2. The output is -2 if the input is greater than -2 and less than or equal to 1. It's 1 if the input is between 1 and 2, including 2, and the output is 2 if the input is anything more than 2. For each interval of inputs, the output was a constant, never-changing value. In fact, what we just wrote there is the function for this graph. This is how piecewise functions are written. Each piece broke it up into input intervals. So let's try taking a step function and graphing it. The first piece here says that it's on the interval less than or equal to -1. On that input interval, the output is always 3. Notice the closed circle where the input is -1. We've discussed this before. That means this piece includes that input. An open circle would mean that the given output doesn't apply at that input. For the next piece, between -1 and 2, we can see that it doesn't include exactly -1 or 2, so there's going to be an open point for both at -3. The final interval is everything 2 and above, and the output for this interval is 1. So this step function looks like this. The output will always be 3, -3, or 1, depending on which interval the input falls into. The most important use of step functions, piecewise functions, or any other function, is knowing what the output will be for a particular input. If the input is 3, what's the output in this function? We've got two ways to figure this out. First, 3 is between 2 and 4, and any input between 2 and 4 gives an output of -2. We could also use the graph. If the input is 3, we can see that the output is -2. All right, so what if the input is -1? The function has two intervals with -1, so which one do we use? Remember that the different symbols here mean different things. The middle piece is only when the input is greater than -1, not equal to it. The other piece of the function, however, uses inputs less than or equal to -1, meaning -1 would fall into this category, so the output is -3. If we use the graph, we can see that there are two points at -1, but an open point doesn't count. So the answer, just like before, would still be -3. We could also mix it up and ask what input gives a specific output. What inputs here give an output of 1? Well, according to the function, there are two different intervals that give outputs of 1, so any inputs that are on those intervals are fair game. The graph shows the same. Two separate intervals full of points where the output is 1. We could say -5, -4.5, or 0, or 1, or 1.5, or 2, or infinitely many other values that fall into these intervals. And they would all be correct answers because each of these inputs gives the same output of 1. Step functions are very easy forms of piecewise functions, functions that are defined in pieces. In the next couple of videos, we're going to extend this idea to more complicated piecewise functions. See you then.